parent, dad. And Phoenicia was a very seafaring civilization. It had a bunch of trading posts all over the Mediterranean Sea and a little bit in other parts of the Middle East, but mostly around Mediterranean, in Italy and Africa and Spain, France, Rome, well, that's Italy, and Greece. And there are four famous trading posts that are important. Byblos, Tyre, and Sidon, and then there's Carthage, and which I think, I'm not sure. And the trading posts were very interesting because, not really, that was very important. They were...
Go ahead.
Okay.
You're fine.
The trading posts were very useful in trading goods to other places in the Mediterranean, but a bad thing about them was that the trading posts had no really good defenses because they were just little outposts by the sea. So that sense, since they had no big walls or anything, Rome eventually attacked them, and that led to the Punic Wars. And Phoenicia is known for purple cloth, and purple is the color of royalty, and it came to be that way because the Phoenicians made a purple cloth out of snail mucus, actual snail, sea snail mucus.
Murex.
Murex snails, they were called, and they would take the snails out of their shells and put them decompose and then take the mucus to turn into a dye, which is very smelly.
Yeah.
So. And it took so many murex snails to make just a little bit of dye that it was very expensive. So then it was color of things. So it was only really good for it. And Phoenicia had a lot of natural resources because Lebanon has a lot of trees. And there are a bunch of trading posts, but they do have a mainland by Israel, I forgot to mention that. And that's only with the trees. And also, of course, that's by the sea, so it's easy to get all the murex things they need. And some things that were in high demand, natural resources, were copper, cypress trees, grain crops and pottery, and they're actually quite skilled with pottery in glass and clay. They made interesting designs. Olives, grapes, and turned wine. Cedar trees, pine trees, mucus, snails, and actual purple cloth. And I made cedar logs. They were in the ship, but
all right, but we'll get to see those upstairs, maybe, when we get up there.
Yeah, also have grapes.
Cool.
And, of course, they were known for the alphabet, and this is the Phoenician alphabet. And it looks kind of weird, except for that one looks busy and a Y, but, and it was modified by the Greeks, and then modified again by the Romans to look into the actual figures that we use today. And they're also known for shipbuilding, and that's where the ship came in. I made a merchant ship, which were sort of rounder to hold all the things that were being sold. And then there were warships, which were a lot more streamlined than the merchant ships, and they were very efficient for sea battle. And then there were the fishing ships, which looked a little bit like the fishing ships that we use today, the unmotorized ones, also made ships for Greece and Rome and other countries. And the purple cloth, correct, was mostly sold to Africa.